side you want it on.
Away on YouTube! Away on YouTube!
We will be.
We will?
Oh, for real? Oh, watch out.
The 7-1 Wendell and Blue and the 8-0 Riley Hill and Green tackled the Pee Wee Final Four. Up for grabs was a repeat Super Bowl berth for the reigning champ Eagles. Spoiler alert, Riley Hill owned the W over the team which wore the W. For the major reason why, let's kick off with introductions. Meet Eagle number 5, Jeremiah Bethel. Dad, Jermaine Bethel, once accumulated 22 tackles behind the line of scrimmage in a single football game for East Wake High, as well as pinning a state heavyweight wrestling title. A legend, but like father, like son, because sons are also stars. Jeremiah Bethel would go supernova in this do-or-die duel. Take, for instance, his very first give, when he got long gone 50 yards for the 6-0 Riley Hill lead. Bethel, affectionately called the bus, was not finished at that finish line. He snowplowed through a Wendell crowd 2 carries later to pile drive another 32. Then he rumbled in from the 5, scoring the 6, and stomping a 12-0 single-footed spread. He later punished on this punt return. Then he took off with the next handoff, where it was hands off. 45 yards, busting open an 18-0 Eagle nest egg. He and his team were walking way away. In the second half, Jeremiah Bethel answered a Ram touchdown in 2 touches. First, this 7-yard bash, then this 36-yard undisturbed dash. His bonus barge built a 27-7 bulge between the squads. His last leg lug powered 9, but his game damage was complete. While his season spree of 28 total touchdowns this fall is ongoing. This frame is just to show Wendell was once able to gather at a bus stop. Then again, the bus can also make stops. Here, for instance. And here, when push came to shove. Or here, via a chase and plant. Here, closing a hole with the old heave-ho. Here, derailing a train in its tracks. Or here, going low to slow an advance. Or here, on a body slam. Or even here, to level the playing field. Seemingly, every enemy player on it. While it's true the Rams lost control of the ball and the competition early, often, and overall, the Blue enjoyed a few shining moments, too. QB Jonathan Montague hit John Tolson for pass spectacles of 23 and later 18 thanks to a terrific solo pawing clutch. The combo just missed on a second quarter bomb.
He got the ball, yeah.
Montague's motor both extended then capped third period threats. He looked to toss but chose to run on a fourth and goal scramble, earning points and praise as the gap briefly shrank to 27. Montague threw Riley Hill for a loop with 3 of 5 completions for 63 yards. But pressure kept him on the defensive end mostly. Rally Hill's Deshaun Wilkinson racked up 45 ground pounds plus this goal stroll. That PAT padded the concluding margin.
Wrap him on, Grayson! There you go!
There he is. Same thing again. Hit it.
Eagle coach Terrence Spencer and company hailed the Pee Wee program's 17th straight victory. Even landing one last lick to sturdy emotions until clashing with equally unbeaten Zeblin this weekend for the crown. The Rams and their faithful did prove to be king of the Wake Forest Middle School heel during the Mighty Mike mauling. The emblem on the sidelines and the helmets matched the strong showing as reserves traded possessions the entire fourth quarter. Assistant coach Ryan Scoggins enjoyed a reverse celebration dousing as the 7-1 pack prepares to face Durham next for Super Bowl supremacy. This is Don Fuller, East Wake Television.